When it comes to NTIs, in the facility that I'm in, it's a neurology clinic, and I don't have a lathe and a handpiece and a grinder and suction. I don't have anything. And I sometimes make an NTI device, and one incisor is longer than the other. Or the opposing teeth, the teeth that oppose my NTI are kind of crooked. It's like, oh, and I can't shave a tooth or shave the plastic and buff the plastic. So I started taking these daytime devices, we used to call them, and I started making two of them at the same time, one on the upper teeth, one on the lower teeth. Because you always make a splint. What's your splint, upper or lower? Well, I went to USC, we make ours on the maxilla. Well, I went to Northwestern, we make it on the lower. There's some sort of territory about where you make your splints, upper or lower, as if you should just make one. And the problem with me making the NTIs is sometimes the opposing teeth are not complying with me. One's long, one's short, which turns, bugs me. What I want is slipperiness. I want lack of friction. I don't want steak knives slicing into my NTI device. I want big fat butter knives on there. So I started taking these daytime devices, because I had bags of them that I was never using, and I would make one on the top and make one on the bottom. Here's the thermoplastic material, but this thing was always too tall, and I forgot to shave that one, and sure enough, I had to go back and grind. Oh, it's too tall. But functionally, or as far as parafunctional management, terrific. And it was almost like cheating. It was so easy to do.